Good afternoon from Okinawa, Japan, home of Okisubis. I got a pretty interesting troubleshooting thing, so we thought that we would share. The car driving would be like a whoa, 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 whoa on light load. We thought, easy diagnosing. That's super easy. It's going to be mass airflow sensor. We swapped out with a brand new mass airflow sensor. Still same issue. Looked at PCV valves and boost leaks and even looked at the borescope and checked to see if the turbo was like seized or something. I don't know. We were trying to figure all kinds of stuff out. Couldn't really figure it out. This is a free firmware, guys, or software. The ROM Raider. You get a Tatrix cable, hook it up, right? And one thing that I started noticing is if you look right here, this is the AFRs. And the computer is reading 11.25, which is as rich as it can read, all the way up to about 22. There's not much that the ECU or engine could do to go from that lean, that rich, that fast. This is your short-term trim. This is your long-term trim. It's also going minus, which means it's pulling fuel, adding fuel to the max. Pulling fuel, adding fuel to the max. But let me show you what the symptoms are. See how it's kind of vibrating right there, that kind of bouncing? That it does that as you're driving. Feels like you got some lowrider riding around on hydraulics or something. So, we unplug the O2 sensor.
So this O2 sensor is the one that controls the air fuel ratio in the headers. This is located in the headers.
With it unplugged,
we get a check engine light, but...
Yeah, so check engine light comes on, but now it becomes dumb. It thinks it's always at 14.7. No AFR is changing now, right? And now if we shoot it up, now it stays the same. So we're gonna find out if this was the actual proper fix or not. If you're actually watching this video, then most likely it's going to be, because we're gonna change out the O2 sensor, and if that fixes it, then it's the O2 sensor that needs to be replaced if you see something like that. Hope it helps for some of those guys trying to find that ghost problem. So we swapped out the O2 sensor and we saw what we wanted to see. Some minor adjustments on this side and then some minor adjustments on this side here. You don't see this going down to 11.25 all the way up to 25. You don't see this going minus whatever it was, plus whatever. It's pretty stable. And now we just go ahead and steady RPMs. So we really wanted to share this video because there obviously was no check engine lights until we unplugged it. So you don't really know that that's going to be specifically an issue. You don't know the O2 sensor specifically, but maybe you don't have ROM Raider, and maybe as you accelerate and you're keeping it at like 3000 RPMs and you got a kind of like a jerking, you know, and you want to try some sensors out without buying the equipment. Hopefully you watch this video. Hopefully you find it and swap out that O2 sensor and get to pulling some good clean runs.